In this video, we'll see how to do multiplication in Turing machine. And here we are going to use subroutine method. Like we have functions, right? Similarly, in case of Turing machine, we have subroutines. So again, it is like the same procedure. We have the inputs represented as like when it is 2 into 3, the inputs are denoted as, for representing 2, we use 2 ones, and for representing 3, we use 3 ones. And to separate these two elements, we use a 0 as a separator, and this is how the input is represented. And finally, the output will be the number of ones. 2 into 3 is 6. Final output will be, we have 6 ones left out in the tape. The remaining elements will be 0. Sorry, remaining elements will be a blank symbol. Okay, so this is how we have to do. And for multiplication, we are going to consider a repeated addition as the process. Like 2 into 3 can be processed as this 3 repeated twice, or this 2 repeated thrice. Okay, so this is how the multiplication is done. And I'm going to take an algorithm that works by for each and every one over here, I'm going to copy these much of ones to this place. Okay, and here I'm going to have a consideration that like, in order to separate this input and output, I'm going to start the process by adding the 0 in the starting state itself. If you want, you can have a transition for making this last blank as a 0, or we can start from first itself. Now I just start with this, like I'm going to assume that the input contains a 0 at the end. Okay, so now for each and every one over here, I'm going to copy these much of ones, that is the second element in this place. Okay, and again come back for this next one, again copy the same over here. So totally, when all the ones in this place are over, we have 6 number of ones, the result alone in the tape. Okay, so this is how my process should work. Now for this copy phase, I have a separate phases. I'm going to design it as a 2 different transition diagram for the process. Okay, so now whenever we start the transition, I have considered the input as 2 into 3. Now this is up to the user to consider. Now whenever we start the process, the input is written on the tape from left to right, and we have a rewrite here that focuses on the first element, and the transition starts from the starting state. This is a standard procedure. Okay, so now what we are going to do, we are going to have, like, we for this one, we are going to copy this set of ones over here. Okay, so here this is like, we are going to consider one, like here it is processed. When you want to denote it as a process, we have to cancel this one to some symbols, and we can make the transition. Now I told you, like, the output alone will be there in the tape after at the end of the transition. So what we can do, we can cancel this one with a blank symbol, and we can have a transition, like we can move till the 0, and once 0 is there, the next element will be the second element. Okay, so we have to copy these set of elements to this place, so we can have a state change after the 0, and then we have to have a copy phase, right? We have, for each and every one over here, we are going to convert one blank symbol to one. For this one, one blank symbol is converted to one, and for the next one, and this blank symbol will be converted. Okay, so here this set of elements are copied over here, and again come back, and we have one more one over here, convert that to a blank symbol, and again for this one, copy the set of elements again to the blank symbol. We have 3 ones, copy 3 ones, and finally what happened, when you come back, there is no more elements left. Okay, so that actually means that the process is completed. So we have to make these alone as a blank symbol, all the remaining elements to a blank symbol, and finally have this alone in the tape. So this will be the algorithm for it, and we are going to design a machine for it. Okay, so the transition starts from the starting state Q0. In Q0, when the input is 1, we are going to convert that 1 to a blank symbol, and we are going to make a right side move transition. Whenever you have a cancellation, have a state change. Okay, so in state Q0, if the input is 1, this 1 is converted to blank symbol, that is, it is cancelled, and we are making a transition to the state Q1. So in Q1, we may have some n number of 1s over here. For all the 1s, we move a step right. Okay, so Turing machine is a place, it makes a single step movement. We can't directly move to the 0. Okay, so each step of transition, it moves a single step. And finally, when it reaches the 0, then we have to have the copy phase. When there is a 0, that 0 will remain as it is, and we make a step right, and this is a place where we want to copy the element. Okay, so copying is the place where we copy these set of elements to this place. Instead of having it in the same direction, same diagram, I can have the copy face as a separate diagram. So here I draw the diagram for this copy face in Q2. So this calls Q2. Now in Q2, what happened? For each and every one in this place, I'm going to convert a blank symbol to one. So here, again, when you want to cancel this, while canceling this one, we are going to use a different symbol. See, we are not going to use a blank symbol for the conversion. The reason is, we use a blank symbol since this one is never ever used. Once I cancel this one, I'm going to copy it, and when coming back, I'm not going to use this. I'm going to use this alone. Okay, so whenever this side, the first element is cancelled, it is cancelled forever. But when you're copying the second element, it need to be recovered back. Okay, so I can use a symbol Y instead of replacing it as a blank symbol. This one is converted to Y, and we are going to move right until we found a blank symbol. So we can have a transition to the state Q3. In Q3, I have a self loop where it moves for all the ones and zeros. When I have 1, move right. When I have 0, move right. When I found a blank symbol, the blank symbol will be converted to 1. Okay, so for 1 over here, 1 blank symbol is converted to 1. Now I can come back and take the next element. So after cancelling this blank symbol to 1, we have to move a left side move. And we are making a transition to Q4. Okay, so in Q4, we are going to make a left side move to take the next one. So this one is converted to Y, and we move right, and we make this blank symbol to 1. Okay, so while coming back, I have to take the next one. Okay, so to denote this one, I have to move till this Y. When I move till this Y, the next element will be the input that I have to cancel. So here I can have a transition. I may have either 0 or 1. For all the zeros, I move left, or all the ones, I move left. And once I have a Y, I have to make a right side move, and again I have to start the process. Okay, I have to copy this one to this place. Okay, so this one will be converted to Y. So that is a recursive procedure. When I have a Y in the tape, that Y will remain as it is. I move a step right and start the transition with Q2. So what this Q2 will do? This Q2 will convert this one to Y and go to state Q3. In Q3, we can move until this blank symbol. This blank symbol will be converted to 1. So this is a recursive procedure. So this one blank is converted to Y. And again, this one will be converted to Y. Again, come back. Okay, so this is all, like all the threes are copied over here. When I come back till this Y, and when I take the next input in Q2, it will be 0. Okay, when the input is 0, it actually means that all the elements are copied. So we have to repeat the procedure, right? So here one cycle is completed. For this one, I have copied these set of elements over here. So one cycle is totally complete. Now I have to go back to take the next one, right? So here when the input is 0 in Q2, it actually means that the process is completed. So I have to go back to take the next one. While going back, what happened? See, I have made a transition of copy face with this input as 1, but I have converted it to Y over here. So all the Y's that we have converted, this Y's will be converted to 1 again. Okay, so here I'm going to make a left side move. All the Y's that we have converted to 1's to Y, right? That will be recovered back. All the Y's are converted to 1 again. We move left. All the zeros will remain as it is. 1's will remain as it is. We have to move until we have a blank symbol. Okay, so we may have some 1, move left, 0, move left. And we have to move until we have a blank symbol. So when we have a blank symbol, so this is your copy face, right? I can have the transition here as Q5. Okay, so this is your copy face. Instead of having it in the same diagram, I have written it separately. So in Q5, when the input is blank, I have to rewrite the same process, right? When the input is blank in Q1, I have to take the next input. Okay, so here the next input is taken in this Q0 phase. When the input is blank, I move a step right and take the next element. So what this Q0 will do? It will convert this 1 to blank and call the copy phase again. It moves till the 0 and call the copy phase. So this process is iterated. So like again, for this one, it is converted to blank. And again, these ones, we copy the elements over here. and again come back to take the next element in Q naught. When the element in the Q naught is zero, it actually means that the process is completed. So here we have the output in the tape as this. So this will be the final output in the tape. So here in Q naught, when the input is zero, it actually means that the output is done. But the problem is we need this portion alone there in the tape. Okay, the remaining elements to be converted to a blank symbol. So when the input is 1, already the previous ones are converted to blank symbol. So the input is 0, the 0 will be converted to blank and move a step right to the state Q6. In Q6, I have a self loop that converts all the second element 1 into blank symbol and we move right. So each and every ones are converted to a blank symbol. And finally, when the input is 0, it actually means that the next element will be your output. Okay, so when the input is 0, the 0 is also converted to a blank since we need this alone in the tape. Okay, the output alone should be there in the tape. So this 0 is converted to a blank symbol and we are going to this Q accept state and this will be your final state. Okay, now after the process, this result alone will be there in the tape. The remaining elements will be converted to a blank symbol. That's it. Thank you.